verses 1 through 8. Him that is weak in the faith, receive, but not to doubt, was contented. I'm going to read the book of Revelation. Romans chapter 14, verse 1 through 8. Receive one who is weak in the faith, but not to dispute over doubtful things. The one who believes he may eat all things, but he who is weak eats only vegetables. Let him who eats despise him who does not eat, and let not him who does not eat judge him who eats, for God has received him. Who are you to judge another servant? Who is master who stands or departs? Indeed, he will be made to stand, for God is able to make him stand. One person esteems one day above another, another esteems every day alone. Let each be fully convinced in his own mind. He who observes the day observes it to the Lord. He who does not observe the day to the Lord, he does not observe it. He who eats, eats to the Lord. He gives God thanks. He who does not eat to the Lord, he does not eat, he gives God thanks. For none of us lives to himself, and no one dies to himself. For if we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. Therefore, whether we live or die, we are the Lord.
Going to say this phrase,
I'd rather be right than be the president. To think about that. Now think, I've never, and I'm maybe even never aspired, younger student, I want to be president of the United States. Maybe that never was your interest. Well, even desire, but not easily, I want to be president. We can relate to that. We can relate to that in a big way, that wanting to be right no matter what. And we really like, if we're really honest, we like it when we're right and the person admits that we're right and they're wrong. About a different scenario, about in the church. The two scenarios is right in the church to always argument if you're right. Is that the best option? Or is it option two, even though you know that it's the right thing, in your heart, you're willing to lose. You remember Romans 14, Paul said the second option is the best option. The second option is something that we need to be about. Let's be honest, folks, not everything in the church is red letter or black letters. It's not in the Word of God. There is areas of gray.
Is the elongus mas. And that big word concern over trifles. Concern over little things. Concern over many things.
Yes, it's not a good one, son. Man struggled with his opinion and wanted it to make his important thing. That's not to be. So it is to the church today. So as we see in this word about this, some commentators and some scholars say, you hear the phrase, it matters to the conscience, if you will. Whatever it is, it's something that God has not specifically said. It's not a command, nor is he forbidden. It's not a command. In other words, if God said this, it doesn't imply to do this. Just like what God said, I want a man to go for it. It's not to consider five, Cyprus, whatever. So we understand that aspect. We're talking about something that is not as clear. Now I must say there is a difference between rather matters of faith and matters of opinion. Matters of faith is much different. We're talking about command. We're talking about doctrinal things. We're talking about things. Hey, here's in the Bible. Here's what it says. Here's what we need to do. We know. Well, as we see in this context, we see that there are several things going on here. Number one is somebody needing them. They would need vegetables. They would need plantations on their animals, their feelings. And they despise the one that only was a vegetarian. So they were at fault by despising the one that only said, no, this is the only thing that I eat. This is the only thing that's clean. Now the one that was the only, they judge the one the members that they believe as well as vegetables. And so there was a problem on both issues. And there was not only a problem when it came to eating and drinking, there was also, if you look further, as was read to us, there was some that would say, every day is a day of God. Every day is a day I'm going to thank God and celebrate. Every day is a day of God. But then there were some specific days that were holy, and they gave that to God. And so we have this problem here. There's people in these matters. They're all being as weak and as strong. And I would say, if we think of a weak member, maybe we might think of someone of little faith, someone that is feeble. But that's not what he means here by weak member. What he means by weak member here is someone that is restricted, that is demanding. That's a weak member. We have someone like that that's weak, that's restricted, that's demanding. They're so demanding. We are justified by our faith. And it doesn't involve, the eating or what we eat or drink, whether we don't eat, whether we specify certain days as being special or we don't. But they didn't seem to do that. And the one who is a strong member is one that was not falling into the man's dreams. Someone that didn't see the idea of clean or unclean. Someone that, if you look at verse 13, that the kingdom of God was about righteousness. It was about peace. It was about joy in the Holy Spirit. They were just impressed at a person. Notice in verse 13, they were to consider the feelings of the other and not cause their other brothers to stumble or fall. The problem that are involved in this disagreement in Romans 14. What I love about the Bible is how practical it is in many things.
principles for someone that would be either member, restricted, or demanding? They've got about justification by faith. They're not about faith. You can see someone that isn't strong, or someone that's not by the demons, but despise your leader.
Making sure
Jesus. And have, watch this, the humility to admit, I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this is an honest one. Maybe this doesn't matter in the kingdom of God. It's about the things in which God specifies. One thing is we need to act towards our conscience on verses. We need to eat the Lord and give thanks to God. If you only eat vegetables, do it to God. Give thanks to God. We need practice in areas of opinion. These are good questions to think about. Number one is, can I do what I'm doing before the Lord? And will it be accepted? Number two is, can I do it in His name and give Him thanks? The answer is yes to both of those. In your heart, it's yes. Do it to the Lord, give Him thanks. So Paul is saying, you eat meat, do it to the Lord, give thanks. You can't eat meat, do it to the Lord, give Him thanks. Let's live to our verse 8, look at verse 8. We all belong to you. That's powerful, isn't it? Well, we know, you know that we remember needs to know this, and this is stuff for you, and preach something on your toes, and you're pursuing and demanding and hearing it. It really don't matter. It's your true lay sign of faith. Person who may be stronger in the faith is not God by tradition, restrictions, and things that are not essential. There's some principles for you to go by as well. Love it. Number one is this, you better stop judging one another. And notice verse 13, resolve the difference. Yeah, I got an amen. Resolve the difference. We should be that conflict. Someone gets upset. Someone gets upset. They tell people that really the bunch of people is not about them. We need to be that conflict resolution. And by doing that, we are not stumbling block to that person. In other words, bigger about what I think and what you think. It should, at the end of the day, be about God. It's His church, is it not? It's not yours, it's not mine. We need to see beyond what we think, how we think, and make sure that we don't despise one another and we resolve that. I think number two is this. Do not destroy with food the one whom Christ died. Look at verse 20. Do not destroy the work of God for the sake of food. Let me tell you something. Christ loved us enough to die for us. Why in the world do we not love our fellow brother and sister enough to Spirit is there in that text. Our behavior is to be guided by what things bring these about? What will lead to peace, joy, righteousness with my Christian brother and my Christian sister? How important for us all to understand. I think Paul was 14 said on all of our focus. You can actually read and take it and read it from a personal. He's talking to me. Sometimes I have people say, Richard, you're preaching me. Number three is we need to keep our views to ourselves. Look at verse 22. Do you have faith? Yeah, I have faith, Paul. Have it to yourself before God. Opinions, keep it to yourself. Practices on the matter to ourselves. Watch this. Mind your own business. Instead of deceiving. Whatever you're disagreeing about in an area of opinion that everyone in the church should know about. We're going to assess ourselves. Forget about who's in here that needs to hear that sermon. Yeah, that person needs that sermon. That person won't come. Look at yourself. See what you're doing. Two thrown me in last Sunday. I need to help. I need to help. What a great visual for all of us. Hey, macho man, you got to be strong. You can't be. You can't cry. You can't show your emotion. At the end of the day, we're talking about brothers and sisters, we're talking about church, how to work in the church. But are you part of the church? Are you in the church? Did the Lord add you to it? And confess it. They don't know Christ is baptized. Those are necessary. They're not open for discussion and debate and thinking about it. Those are necessary. necessary things. If the Bible says must, you must. We all want to say we're a stronger person, but are we in it? Are we at all times? We sometimes, maybe for honest, we fall that we think brother or sister because of things in my mind, power, what I think, and so forth. Love and attention already sends to all of us to assess our own life and to examine ourselves whether or not we're in the faith, and to make sure, first and foremost, that my life is where it needs to be. Forget about it. I hate that I'm selfish, but you have to love, if you love your neighbor, you have to love your neighbor yourself. You have to think of yourself here. And making sure your life is where it needs to be. Make the testimony to dedicate your life, your strength, your wisdom, maybe a big burden that you're carrying, that Christ has offered us a higher goal. When you come, that time is spent together with us.